Once again, you all are welcome in the lecture series of Artificial Intelligence. Today, in this lecture, we will cover one of the very important algorithm used in Artificial Intelligence, that is MEA, Mean End Analysis. And I found various sources on the net, but I found no one is, you know, going able to explain it properly. So I found this opportunity and make this video. I hope you understand this, and if you understand, kindly like, share and subscribe my channel. So without wasting time, let us start this. We covered yesterday, you know, most of the topics like simple hill climbing. This we covered. Steepest ascent hill climbing. This is the another type of the hill climbing. Stochastic. This we covered in the last lecture. And the problems also, what are the various problems in hill climbing, local maxima, plateau and ridge, and stimulating annealing. We ended our lecture here. So now we will start the today's lecture. This is very important. And today's lecture is about MEA. This is also called, this algorithm is also termed as MEA in short. And most of the time it is asked in like this, write a short note on MEA, Mean End Analysis. Now what is this algo? This is a very, very, very important algorithm used in the AI after the hill climbing algo. This is a very important. Now let us start. We have studied the strategies which can reason either in forward and the backward, but a mixture of the two direction is appropriate for solving a complex and the large problem. Till now we use, you know, forward tracking or backward tracking, these kind of searches. But you know, for some complex problem, we need some strategy in which we can use forward as well as backward direction as a mixed strategy. So such a mixed strategy make it possible that first to solve the major part of the problem and then go back and solve the smaller problems arises during the combining the big parts of the problem. So what we do, we generally break a big problem into the smaller modules, and then we work on the smaller modules and then club them. And while clubbing, there are some problems, we overcome that also. Such a technique is what we call means ends analysis. I think it is not clear through this definition. I'll give you one example that will clear this thing. Let us suppose you want to become a programmer. You all are IT student and you want to become a, you know, programmer, developer. And here is right now you are student. Now you want to, you know, become a IT programmer. From student to, this is your journey. From student to IT developer. So how you will become a developer? For that you have to, you know, carry out some small steps, like you have to learn HTML, you have to learn several things like CSS and several things. So you break your whole journey into the smaller modules, and then what do? You have to, you know, take an action. Action in a sense means you have to complete this HTML first, then you have to learn the CSS first. So after some time, let us suppose this is 6 months. So after the 6 month time, you will become an IT developer. So here the problem is that you want to become an IT developer from a student, and you break that problem into the smaller modules, then you proceed through the smaller module covering all the concepts, and then you will become an IT developer. This is just like a mean end analysis. In what we do here also the same thing, we break the big problem, the major part of the problem, and then go back and solve the smaller problem, and then combining it to solve the big problem. The same thing, let us suppose you cleared this HTML and moved towards CSS. While working on CSS, you have to learn some missed concept which you missed in HTML. So you go back and learn that again, so that your knowledge get updated and then you will become a developer. So these are the phases which will help you to become a developer. And in during these phases, several times you go back and learn something new and move forward. So this is what the mean end analysis algorithm all about. So let us move forward. Mean end analysis is a problem solving technique used in the AI for a limiting search in AI problems. It is a mixture of backward and forward. This is a very important point. Everyone should have to write it in the exam, that mean end analysis algorithm. Mean end analysis algorithm. Please mute yourself. Okay, Nidhi Singh and Mohammed Asif joined late. Why Mohammed Asif, where are you? Why you are late today?
Sir, electricity chali gayi thi, sir.
Okay, no problem. Right, so we are doing mean end analysis. Now I will start again. The mean end analysis, that is MEA technique, was first introduced in 1961 by Alan Newell and Herbert A. Semon in their program solving computer program, which was the name the general program solver, GPS. The MEA analysis process centered on the evaluation of the difference between the current state and the goal state. This is very important. Mean end analysis, you know, it works on two things. One is your current state and another is your goal state. Like I'll give you example, you want to become a programmer. So this is your goal state, to become an IT programmer and or developer. And current state is you are student. So, but at every step, and you do first HTML one thing, then second thing CSS, and similarly so on, you do several things. So at every step, you know, you calculate the difference, how much, you know, the difference is left behind to become a, to achieve your goal. So every time, at every stage, you come up with to calculate the distance, that is what we call difference. So once the difference becomes zero, you will achieve your goal state. So this is how the mean end analysis, that's why it is called mean end analysis, because we are analyzing the ends, where we are and where we have to reach. So we searches the ends and then we move gradually towards our goal. So now let us come to its working, how mean end analysis work. Mean end analysis process can be applied recursively. There is a word recursive. Recursive, I told you, in recursive means what? With the previous value, you are going to calculate the next value. I think you learned it in your MCA first in mathematics. The recursion is one of the chapter in your course. Recursion means by using the previous value, you have to solve the next value like this. An is equal to an minus 1, 3an plus minus 1 plus 2. So by knowing the previous value, you are able to, you know, calculate the next value. This is what we call recursion. Here also, in mean end analysis also, this is the same thing get happen. When you are doing the second module, the second module use the concept of the first module. Because HTML and CSS, so while learning CSS, definitely you need to learn the concepts of HTML. Before that, you can't do the second concept. So this is what here it is explained. The mean end analysis process can be applied recursively for a problem. It is a strategy to control search in a problem solving. And following are the steps. Number one, first, evaluate the difference. Very important. First of all, you have to check. Like being a student, maybe you know some things. So you are not a beginner, because you up to this MCA student, you learn a lot, you know, after in BCA or any your graduation program, and from first to 12th class, you learn many things. So everybody, you know, most of the student have some concept, somebody have no, do not have any concept. So the difference is lying between, you know, your present scenario and your goal state, what you want to become. So that's why evaluate the difference between initial state and the final state. And for every problem, it is, you know, different. For everyone, it is different. every case it is different. So select the various operators. Now what you have to do, once you know the difference, now you have to take an action. Action means, like, let us suppose you have some additional knowledge about something else that is not required here. So you have to use the delete operator. Delete operator means you have to skip that thing from your mind. You have to remove that thing from your mind which is not in this process, and you have to just added is another operator. So adding, removing, these are the operators that we generally use to solve the problem, these kind of problems. So this is what the various operators are discussed here. Now apply the operators at each difference. At every stage you have to apply some operator. It depends, like the first step is HTML and you know that, so you added it and then move towards next one, and after completing that you also added that. So apply the operator at each difference, which reduces the difference between the current state and the goal state. Means you have to progressively, you have to move towards your goal up, and calculating the difference at the each stage, and so that you came to understand how much, you know, labor you have to do more to achieve your goal state. I'm giving this example because this is easy to understand. Now there is one very important term, and it is sometimes asked in the exam. What is operator sub goaling? What is operator sub goaling? Very important. In the MEA process, in the mean end analysis process, we detect the difference between the current state and the goal state. This we all understand now. And once this difference occurs, then we apply the operator. This we all already know. I have already told you. You have to do the first step, that is calculate the difference. Then the second step, you have to apply the operator. Now, but sometimes what has happened, it is possible that the operator cannot be applied to the current state. Sometimes this has happened that operator cannot be applied to the current state. So we create a sub program. Then in that case, what we do? We subdivided that task in which the operator can be applied, so that we can apply the operator, like addition, subtraction, whatsoever the operator. Such type of backward chaining in which the operators are selected and then some goals are set up, this is what we call operator sub-goaling. So operator sub-goaling, what we do, we generally subdivided our goal, means the problem, we subdivided it so that our operator must be applicable over there, because from first state to the another state, you must have to apply any one of the operator. Without applying operator, you can't move from one state to another state. Now sometime what will happen, there are so many states, but there is no reason, you know, sometimes it is not possible to apply operator. So what we do, we generally break this into two parts, means subdivided the problem, and then we apply the operator, either join or delete or add, and then this thing can be overcome. This is what we called operator sub-goaling. It is suggested from its name also. Sub-goaling means you divided the goal into sub-part, means you divided the state into any number of parts. So let us move forward. This is again very important for the exam. Now, algorithm for mean analysis, I already told you. So these are the steps only you have to learn. Step one, this is how you have to write it in your exam also. If somebody asks you what is algorithm, so first of all, compare current and goal state. If there is no difference, so it means you are at the goal state, return success and exit. I think it is very easy to understand. You have to divide your problem into current and the goal state, and if there is no difference, it means you are already on the goal state and exit. Otherwise, what you have to do in the second step, select a new operator. You have to apply the operator and attempt to, you know, move towards the goal state. If your goal state is reached, then you have to exit. Otherwise, you have to repeat the steps again and again. This is how you can write it in your own language also. Don't copy it. I'll advise you to, you can write it in your own language, because this is how algorithm can be written. So we'll move forward. This is a very simple. Now example, very important. This is a very important example. Let us take an example where we know the initial state and the goal state. This is the initial state. This is the goal state. This is nothing as an. This is a diagram where you have a dot, and you have a square, you have a circle. I am just taking this as an example. This is nothing I have to, you know, with relation with some real life example. This is something. You have a problem where there is a dot, there is a circle, there is a square. Now you want to achieve this goal state, means the circle as it is, and you want this square, but outside the circle and some bigger in size. Okay, this we want to achieve. Now what you have to do? First of all, you have to calculate the difference. Difference means you have to analyze how much, you know, you have to do from moving from initial state to the goal state. I'll give you example. What we have to do? We have to remove this. We want to remove this dot because it is not present in the final. And also we want, first of all, to remove this square from inside the circle to the outside. And the third one, the step that we need is, you know, to enlarge its size, to make its size bigger. So let's see how we proceed. Solution is, so this is the initial state that I already explained you. The initial state is this. So first is, you have to apply the delete operator. Delete operator means, because in your goal you don't need this dot. So first of all, the first very first step is you have to remove this dot. So okay, dot is removed. Now applying move operator. Move operator is used to, you know, moving this inner square to the outside. So we'll move, see, after the third step we move this at the upper right side. Or you may create one more step, like just first of all move it here, then move it here. So it depends upon you how much steps you are making. So you initially you moved it straight away here. Now okay, now we want to enlarge its size, so we need one expand, you know, expand operator to increase its size, and this is your goal state. So this is a procedure how to, you know, move from the initial states to the goal state. Every time what we do, we calculate the difference. Means after reaching this, I know the difference is we have to remove this square from the inside to the outside first, and then what is the difference now left? Only difference left is we want to increase the size of this. So for this you need to use an expand operator which expanded the size of this square. So this all about the mean and analysis algorithm, and this is one of the most important algorithm used in AI for different applications, for making games or to solve puzzle like this, or TikTok to game, or any puzzle like this where you have to need some moves, you can apply this algorithm. So I hope I'm able to explain this mean and analysis to you all. So let me ask some, if you have some questions or query. Yes, anybody?
Sir, subgoaling operator, subgoaling bataya tha na bhi aapne.
Ha, subgoaling.
Wo sir ek bar bata do, agar aap matlab crux bata doge uska ek bar kya hai.
No problem.
Wo thoda easy ho jayega.
मैं अभी आपको बताता हूँ. सी, निश्चल इज आस्किंग वन क्वेश्चन, दैट इज व्हाट इज ऑपरेटर, यू नो, सब गोलिंग. ऑपरेटर सब गोलिंग इज समटाइम्स व्हाट विल हैपन व्हाइल अचीविंग, यू नो, वी ब्रेक वन थिंग. यू आई थिंक यू ऑल अंडरस्टैंड दैट फॉर अ मीन एंड एनालिसिस यू हैव टू फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल ब्रेक अ प्रॉब्लम. यू हैव सम इनिशियल स्टेज, यू हैव सम फाइनल स्टेज. Initial stage, anything. Okay, we will take the same example. Anything you may take any example. This is the initial state, and this is a goal state. And something what we generally do, we create some steps, or that is what we call, we break this problem in order to achieve this goal. Now, एट एवरी स्टेप यू हैव टू यू नो अप्लाई सम ऑपरेटर लाइक इन द एग्जाम्पल डेट आई शो यू 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 हैव टू यूज फर्स्ट डिलीट ऑपरेटर टू डिलीट दैट डॉट एंड देन यू यूज द मूव ऑपरेटर टू मूव द स्क्वेयर आउटसाइड फ्रॉम द सर्कल and then you use the expand operator to just increase the size of this sphere. Now actually what I want to told you, at every step you know you need some operator to operate, at every arrow you need some operator, but sometime what will happen, you know, the state is coming there where no operator is needed, means these two, let us suppose these two are same, so but we it means what it means either it may convey you two messages, either the no operator is required here, then the question arises, why we created this step? Definitely there must be some reason behind that, so that reason is, you know, not easily seenable through this step, but it is lying on maybe some speed issue is there. That's why you created one more state, so that it will take some time to get operated. So what will happen here, you subdivided this problem into two parts. When you subdivided it, maybe some reason get, you know, evaluate. Kuch na kuch reason yahan se nikal ke aayega ki why you created this state. And then you apply some operator, then you are able to apply some operator like delete it. Like in the first case, let us suppose you remove the square, but you want the square over here. So आपने क्या किया, इस प्रॉब्लम को सबडिवाइड कर दिया. सबडिवाइड करने के बाद हो सकता है कि वहाँ पे ऑपरेटर लग जाए, कोई ना कोई ऑपरेटर वहाँ पे यूज हो जाए. ऐसी प्रॉब्लम्स को हम लोग ऑपरेटर सब गोलिंग कहते हैं. देखो यहाँ से मैं आपको फिर पढ़ के सुनाता हूँ. वी क्रिएट अ सब प्रॉब्लम. कब क्रिएट करेंगे सब प्रॉब्लम? ऑफ द करंट स्टेट इन विच ऑपरेटर कैन बी अप्लाइड, जहाँ पे ऑपरेटर लग सके. Such type of backward chaining in which the operators are selected and the sub goals are set up to establish the precondition of the operator is called operator subloading, operator sub goaling. I hope समझ में आ गया होगा. Nishal?
Yes sir. Yes sir.
Okay. Okay. Anybody have any problem? You may ask me, or I'll ask you people now. Okay. So, विनीता आपको समझ में आया बेटा? विनीता
yes, समझ आ गया.
हाँ, अभी आप ये बताओ कि मीन एंड एनालिसिस होता क्या?
सर बेसिकली ये इधर फॉरवर्ड और बैकवर्ड टेक्निक्स है. हम मॉड्यूल्स के बेसिस पे काम कर रहे हैं. लाइक जो आपने एग्जांपल दिया था कि हम सेमेस्टर में पढ़ते हैं सब्जेक्ट एचटीएमएल और सीएसएस, तो उसी का बेस्ट एग्जांपल हुआ कि हम मतलब एक स्मॉल मॉड्यूल्स में उसको डिवाइड कर देते हैं हमारे कोर्सेज को. जैसे हमें प्लेसमेंट्स के लिए काफ़ी सारी चीज़ें चाहिए होती है, जैसे डेटा स्ट्रक्चर पढ़ना है, एचटीएमएल सीएसएस, और मतलब अलग अलग मॉड्यूल्स हैं. डेटा साइंटिस्ट वाले मॉड्यूल्स अलग हैं, इसके लिए टीवीएम इम्पॉर्टेंट है. तो वो उनको हम ऐसे डिवाइड करके पढ़ते हैं, एक एक टास्क को कम्प्लिश करते हैं. तो उसके बाद लास्ट में
और जो मेन क्या है आप करके आ रहे हो, आपके इनिशियल स्टेज और फाइनल स्टेज के बीच में जो डिफरेंस है, मतलब जो एक आपको एमसीए की डिग्री के लिए जो क्रेडिट चाहिए थे और जो क्रेडिट आज की डेट में आपके पास है, तो आप क्या कर रहे हो, धीरे धीरे उन क्रेडिट्स को गेन करते हुए उस डिफरेंस को कम कर रहे हो. और वंस वो डिफरेंस जीरो हो जाए, मतलब वो डिफरेंस ना रहे, मतलब आपने सारे क्रेडिट अचीव कर लिए, नाउ यू आर एबल टू यू नो गेट दैट डिग्री, राइट? सो आई थिंक एवरीबडी नाउ अंडरस्टैंड दिस. किसी को कोई पूछना है? केतन, यस, आपको समझ में आया? केतन द्विवेदी,
सर एक क्वेश्चन था.
केतन द्विवेदी लेफ्ट कर गया. ओके, कौन पूछ रहा है क्वेश्चन?
सुनील दिस साइड.
हाँ सुनील, सुनील यस.
सर आपने जो एग्जांपल दिया गया हमें फाइनल स्टेप के लिए, हमारे प्लेसमेंट के लिए हम स्टेप बाय स्टेप चीजें प्रिपेयर करते हैं ताकि एक टाइम पे पूरा बर्डन ना आए.
नहीं,
ऐसे नहीं कि वो बटन ना है, ऐसा नहीं है.
देखो मैं आपने ना इसको थोड़ा सा मिसअंडरस्टूड किया, आई विल एक्सप्लेन। मीन एंड एनालिसिस क्या है, आपके पास एक इनिशियल स्टेज है और एक आपके पास फाइनल स्टेज है। आप अपने गोल को अचीव करना चाहते हो, तो गोल को अचीव करना चाह रहे हो और अभी नहीं कर पा रहे हो, तो इसका मतलब क्या है, देयर इज सम डिफरेंस ना, इसमें कुछ डिफरेंस है। अब आपको करना क्या है, आप उस डिफरेंस को कम करते जा रहे हो, तो आप जब डिफरेंस को जीरो कर दोगे तो ऑब्वियसली आपका गोल आपको मिल जाएगा। जैसे कि अगर मैं प्लेसमेंट की बात करूँ, प्लेसमेंट के लिए अब आप लोगों को क्या है, प्लेसमेंट के लिए आपको वो तैयारी करनी है, एप्टीट्यूड की, रीजनिंग की आप तैयार कर रहे हो उसको, और अपना टेक्निकल भी आप अपना सॉलिड कर रहे हो, तो ये और गोल क्या है, आपको जॉब चाहिए। तो जब आपके जो जॉब के रिक्वायरमेंट्स हैं, रिक्वायरमेंट्स का मतलब रिक्वायरमेंट क्या क्या है, उसका टेक्निकल आपको इंटरव्यू भी ब्रेक करना है, उसका लॉजिकल इंटरव्यू भी ब्रेक करना है, रीजनिंग भी ब्रेक करनी है, जब आप अपने वो सारे गोल्स, वो सारी चीज़ों को अचीव कर लोगे, तो वो जो डिफरेंस है ना वो ज़ीरो हो जाएगा। लेट अस सपोज डिफरेंस था 100, अभी अभी की स्टेज में और आपको फाइनल स्टेज में, आपने उस डिफरेंस को कम करने के लिए आपने क्या किया, आपने स्टडी करी, एप्टीट्यूड को स्ट्रॉन्ग करा और एप्टीट्यूड का पेपर क्लियर कर लिया, तो आपने 50 स्कोर कर लिया, स्टिल अभी 50 स्कोर और बचा है। उसके लिए आपने इंटरव्यू को भी प्रिपेयर कर लिया, आपने एप्टी को भी प्रिपेयर कर लिया, सब कुछ प्रिपेयर कर लिया, तो जब आप वो इंटरव्यू क्लियर कर लेते हो तो वो 50 स्कोर जो डिफरेंस था, वो गैप था, वो भी अचीव हो गया। तो वंस दिस डिफरेंस इज ज़ीरो, जब ये ज़ीरो हो गया इसका मतलब आपने गोल स्टेट अचीव कर ली। ऑब्वियसली जब तुमने इंटरव्यू क्रैक कर दिया और तुमने एग्जाम क्रैक कर दिया तो तुम्हारा सिलेक्शन हो गया कंपनी में, तुम्हें जॉब मिल गई। तो दिस इज हाउ दिस यू नो एल्गोरिथम वर्क्स, राइट। अभी मैं किससे बात कर रहा था, एक केतन, केतन यस डू यू हैव एनी प्रॉब्लम इन दिस, केतन माइक को ऑन करके बोलो बेटा। ओके ये बोल नहीं पा रहा है, राइट। सो एनीबडी हैव एनी प्रॉब्लम टिल नाउ, नो। सो राइट डाउन वन क्वेश्चन फॉर टुडेज असाइनमेंट। द क्वेश्चन नंबर वन इज व्हाट इज, राइट अ शॉर्ट नोट ऑन MEA, राइट अ शॉर्ट नोट ऑन MEA, मीन एंड एनालिसिस एल्गो। नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, व्हाट इज ऑपरेटर सब गोलिंग रिलेटेड टू MEA, व्हाट इज ऑपरेटर सब गोलिंग रिलेटेड टू MEA। नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, गिव वन एग्जाम्पल ऑफ MEA mentioning the steps involved.
सर रिपीट करना क्वेश्चन।
गिव द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ MEA मीन एंड एनालिसिस Mentioning some examples, mentioning the steps involved.
सर बस तीन क्वेश्चन है ना।
हाँ तीन ही क्वेश्चन है। दिस इज ऑल अबाउट यू नो द टुडेज लेक्चर।